This particular video is about letting you know of the newly launched fixed interest rate education loan options. I'll tell you the details of that product, such as interest rate, etc., and I'll also help you compare it with the other floating interest rate education loan options. It is only just 2 weeks ago that some of the lenders came with this new product. Sounds good, right? The interest rate will not change, you are in a safe position, you need not worry about lender increasing your interest rate. But what is not good about this new product is that, and there is one more very important thing which we are missing here. Floating interest rate doesn't always mean that it'll go up. It can come down as well. But I have a surprise great news for you here, and after listening to that, you may not want to go for fixed interest rate option. Hello all, this is Damini, co-founder of VMake Scholars, India's largest education finance platform. So we started in the year 2015 with funding and support from Government of India, and our sole purpose is to help students like you get a scholarship or an education loan for your higher education abroad. Hence, our videos are the most trusted source of information than watching some random blogger. Even though we are sharing the information through these videos, but if any bank staff in your city denies accepting any information which is shared by us or is contradicting it, then we are just a call away. Just call us, we will speak to that bank manager and we'll resolve the issue for you. So LoanFlix web series talks about everything about education loans, and this particular video is about letting you know of the newly launched fixed interest rate education loan options. I'll tell you the details of that product, such as interest rate, etc., and I'll also help you compare it with the other floating interest rate education loan options. So let's start. So before I start telling you about the fixed interest rate education loan options, let me tell you what exactly is the difference between fixed interest rate and floating interest rate education loan options. So as the name sounds, fixed interest rate means the interest rate would stay the same for the entire loan tenure, which means whatever interest rate you're approved a loan at, you repay the entire loan at the same interest rate for the entire loan tenure. And floating interest rate means that if your loan was approved at, let's say, X percentage, the next year the interest rate can be higher than X or it can be lesser than X. So here is one thing which I want to clarify. Floating interest rate doesn't mean that it'll keep changing on a daily basis or on hourly basis like stock market. Floating interest rates are based on the bank's base rate, which is either called as EBLR or MCLR or repo rate. Banks update these base rates once every month. Yeah, so if you go for a fresh loan sanction, whatever is the base rate for that month, based on that, your interest rate will be calculated. But now let's say you're an existing customer. You took the loan 6 months ago or 7 months ago from the bank. Your interest rate in floating interest rate also will not be reset on a monthly basis. It will be reset as per the reset period, which is generally mentioned on your loan agreement. So reset period is usually 1 year, or sometimes it can be 2 years or 3 years also. So how this works is, so let's say you take a loan today in October 2024. And your reset period is 1 year. Even though in November or December or in Jan, the interest rate might change or the base rate might change, your reset of the floating interest rate will only happen in October 2025 because your reset period is 1 year. So it doesn't change monthly for the existing customers. It will only change as per the reset period. The reset period should ideally be mentioned on your loan agreement, but sometimes it is not. In such scenarios, your VMake Scholars financial officer will be able to help you get that clarity from the bank or the NBFC. Many a times, the bank or the NBFC, they are not transparent about such terms. That's why when you apply for your loan through VMake Scholars, you will have a more in-depth understanding and you'll be able to do the right comparison of your loan options. To get in touch with us, you can either call us on the number which is shown on the screen, or you can request a callback via the link which is in the video description. So a few private lenders have recently launched the fixed interest rate education loan options. Earlier in India, all education loans were given with the floating interest rate policy, and it is only just 2 weeks ago that some of the lenders came with this new product. Sounds good, right? The interest rate will not change, you are in a safe position, you need not worry about lender increasing your interest rate. But what is not good about this new product is that the rates in the fixed education loan interest option is at least 2% higher than what the same bank is offering for the same product in floating interest rate option. So where the rate was 10.75% in the floating interest rate product, for the same product it is now 13% if you want to go for fixed interest rate. Where the rate was 12%, now it is going to be 14% in the fixed interest rate policy. So the question here is it worth paying 2-2.5% higher interest rate just for the peace of mind that the rate will not go up? According to me, no, it's a bad deal. But let's dig deep into the details. firstly, let us understand how much do these floating interest rates actually float. So this is a common question which we get asked very frequently, that if I decide to go with a bank on a floating interest rate policy, how much of an increase or a decrease I should expect in my loan tenure in that floating interest rate. So for that, you need to understand that the premium percentage will not change. Now, by premium percentage, I mean when the bank gives you a sanction letter, they write it like MCLR plus, let's say, 2% or 1.5%. Now, this 1.5% or 2% is your premium which the bank is charging. In an ideal case scenario, bank is not supposed to change this premium. Of course, keeping aside these scenarios when the bank is facing some sort of financial crisis. Now, talking about this MCLR or repo rate portion, this is the variable portion. And this is something which changes. On an average, this portion changes by a percentage of 0.25%, 2.5% on an average in a year. Which means in an 8 years period, this can change by maximum 1-1.5%. And I'm saying this by considering the past data of last 8 years. And that also in the last 8 years, these fluctuations were very prominent. If you guys know that, because after COVID, the rates fell down drastically. And a year after that, the rates went back with a much higher pace. And now the rates are higher than the pre-COVID era. So this was about public sector banks. If you're going for a private bank or an NBFC, they play even clever with these figures, that they change the premium component also sometimes. So if you're going for such a private bank or an NBFC option, expect a 2.5 to 3% increase in your 8 years period. Now, why I'm talking about 8 years always? Because that's the average we have seen the students take to close the loan from the sanction date to the closure date. About 2-3 years of moratorium period and about 5 years of repayment on an average leads them to close the loan. That's why I spoke to you in the 8 years term in this whole section. So now when you're doing this 8 years comparison and you want somebody to help you with those calculations, your financial officer is the best person to guide you on that. Every financial officer at VMAX Scholar sanctions about 30 to 50 sanctions every month. And that is way higher than any SBI bank branch or bank branch of any bank. That's why financial officers are the experts and they can guide you inside out of this product. If you haven't been assigned a financial officer yet, you can request a callback via the link which is in the video description, or you can directly call us on the number which is shown on the screen. So coming back to the topic, even if the private bank or NBFC increases the rate by 3% in the floating interest rate product, it will not happen immediately. They may increase 1% after first year, then another 0.5% after second year. So it'll happen eventually. But in the case of fixed interest rate option, you will have to pay that 2-2.5% higher interest rate right from day one rather than paying it eventually. So that option is definitely costlier. I mean, paying it right from day one, the extra amount, it makes it more expensive than paying it over the tenure. And there is one more very important thing which we are missing here. Floating interest rate doesn't always mean that it'll go up. It can come down as well. I mean, during COVID, immediately after COVID, the next year, the interest rates fell down and a lot of people reaped that benefit of the lower interest rates at that point in time. So keeping all these things in mind, I will personally not go for a fixed interest rate option. I know there is a bit of luck factor here. What if the economy goes bad and the rates go drastically up? I know that can happen as well. So I am giving you my opinion based on what is probable. I am not an astrologer here to predict it accurately. So if you want to go for a fixed interest rate education loan option, just to be on safe side, VMAX Scholars team can help you even with that option. So to get in touch with our team, you can call us on the number which is shown on the screen, or you can request a callback via the link in the video description. But I have a surprise great news for you here, and after listening to that, you may not want to go for fixed interest rate option. So VMAX Scholars offers you a unique feature which is interest rate protection scheme. And with interest rate protection scheme, we assure you that when you take your education loan through VMAX Scholars from any private bank or NBFC, your interest rate will never be increased. And if the lender increase your interest rate, we will talk to them and we will get your interest rate reverted to what was the original ROI. And in worst case scenarios, if they are not able to do that because of financial crisis and they cannot stop charging you the higher interest rate, we get your education loan shifted to another lender with a lower interest rate with zero processing or shifting cost. Now you see, you can comfortably go for the floating interest rate option and reap the benefits if the interest rate comes down, because we will not let it go up for you. And I'm repeating again, all the services of VMAX Scholars are at absolutely free of cost because we are funded and supported by the Ministry of IT, Government of India. To get in touch with us, you can directly call us on the number which is shown on the screen. That's it for this video, and I'm repeating repeating again, whether you want to go for fixed interest rate option or the floating interest rate option, both the choices are available with VMAX Scholars Financial Officer and you can pick your preference. If you're having any confusions or questions around it, you can put it in the comments and we'll give you a detailed answer to resolve your confusion. And if you found this episode useful, please subscribe to our channel. The subscribe button is right there and do hit the like button and share it with your friends and colleagues. If you want us to make a video on a specific topic, you can mention that in the comments as well and the next video will be on that. Stay tuned for my next episode. See you soon.